Hi folks, I'm Voba. I am a singer and a vocal trainer, and this is my channel about anatomical vocal training.
Do-ka-do-a.
Today I will talk about under and over pressure in the lungs and how a loose belly can help with that. Now, we as singers, we work with air. We kind of have to control our airflow, our breathing, in order to be able to sing. If we can't control it, we can't hold a note, we can't really sing. What we want to achieve optimally is the most freedom for our voice, that we can work with our voice however long or short we want to and we choose to, in order not to be dependent upon, I need to take a breath again, or I need to push in order to reach that note. We don't want that. So what we want to create, or what we want to play with, is overpressure, underpressure in our lungs. Basically, we want to avoid overpressure in our lungs, and we want to create underpressure in our lungs. What does that mean? Overpressure means you have a container and you have more pressure in this container than the pressure around this container. Right here, the container is our lungs, right? We have our lungs as a container for air, and we can have either more pressure or less pressure, or the same pressure as the air around us. For instance, if you close the vocal cords and you contract everything, that creates an overpressure in your lungs. So you contract everything, the container gets smaller and the air wants to go out. That's an overpressure. Now, if you do the opposite, you have a container, you close the container, and then you expand the container, you have an underpressure, meaning air wants to come into the container to balance the air again from the outside the container and inside the container environment. So if you sing, you kind of like close your vocal cords. They're not fully closed because they vibrate, you know, but you kind of like stop the airflow or control the airflow at least. And that's how you can create overpressure or underpressure in your lungs. Because if your vocal cords really close pretty tightly, pretty neatly, I should rather say, when you sing, then it can be almost as if you close them like holding your breath. It can be a very similar feeling and a similar effect with the right muscles of your breathing apparatus in use. So the vocal cords are the only way that air can enter or exit your lungs, right? So if you close your vocal cords and you produce an overpressure, so you push everything together and you pull the belly in and you contract your rib cage in, then the air will push against your vocal cords. It will push against the entire walls of your lungs, but it will also push against the vocal cords, and that is kind of like the weakest point, because it's the point where that can open, where the air can flow out. The other way around, if you close the vocal cords and you expand your body, your lungs, then the air wants to come in from above the vocal cords. The vocal cords are pulled downward, right? Because there is under pressure. Like with this bottle. If you have that bottle and I put a little water in here. The water represents your intestines. And you now put something on top, like closing the vocal cords, right? This is your lungs, your intestines, your lungs. Then you put something on top, you close your vocal cords to sing or to just hold your breath. And then you push against it, the pressure in the bottle will push against your hand because the air wants to come out. The other way around, if you push against it first, then you put something on top and then you let go, there's under pressure in the bottle and the bottle will suit your hand inside, right? It wants the air to come in so that it can go back to a relaxed state without over or under pressure. We will use that to our advantage. We want to create that under pressure for a few different points. First of all, we don't want the air push anymore, so we can really use the cricothyroid pass oblique for stretching the vocal cords and not have the crutch of more air blow through the vocal cords. Secondly, the under pressure allows us to keep more air in our lungs for a longer period so that we can sing longer phrases. Thirdly, the under pressure in the lungs, as I just demonstrated, pulls the vocal cords slightly downwards, away from the vocal folds, so that the vocal folds and the vocal cords are further away from each other. That is firstly good because it's healthy, so that you don't rub against each other, vocal cords, vocal folds, and also it has a few sound perks that I will get into in a later video. Now, in this whole process, loosening your belly is very important, because if you have a tight belly, your belly muscles will push against your intestines, and your intestines, look at the bottle of the water in the bottle, which is your, represents your intestines, they will be pushed up towards the diaphragm, which means towards the lungs, creating overpressure on the lungs. You don't want that. We don't want that. Any belly pressure, we don't need that. In my next video, I will tell you what to use instead for supporting the voice and what is actually my definition of support for the voice. Have a beautiful day. Oh, subscribe. You can subscribe to my channel if you want to hear more of this. You can like the video if you like the video. It will help me and the algorithm a lot. Me with the algorithm, with that thing. And I will see you when I see you.